The scale at which dams are planned is mind-boggling. We've got hundreds of dams planned. Just in the state of Arunachal Pradesh, they're planning over 160 dams. And these are not small dams. You've got dams of 2,000 megawatts, 2,700 megawatts. Just imagine the size of those dams, the amount of inundation that's going to take place, forests being destroyed, people being displaced. Downstream, it's going to be huge impacts. I mean, downstream of the Ganga. I mean, Ganga goes across the width of India practically, then into Bangladesh, Brahmaputra, the entire northeast. So downstream is not just sort of a few kilometers or a few miles down from where the dam is or where the discharge is. Downstream is right up to the delta. In fact, when sediments are not being carried, there have been studies which show that the delta is affected. Dams in the Himalayas are geologically fragile. They're still a young mountain system in geological terms, and hence we've got landslides everywhere. Constructing so many dams is resulting in a lot of the muck and debris being dumped into the very rivers they are damming. How can you do something where you are putting at risk the very river in which you're generating power from? We don't know what climate change is going to end up doing, because once the glaciers have melted, there will be significantly less water, because then it'll only be based on how much rainfall is there. And it's also predicted that we will not have such continuous monsoons. There would be fewer days of rain and more intense. There are strong movements against particular dams. The focus is now shifting from dam-centric opposition to entire river and river basin planning and looking at conserving and protecting entire rivers.